Hi. So here in this video, I'm actually using now my new Linux laptop. So I switched completely, and I wanted to see how it works and try it out. So it was a steep learning curve, but with some help from ChatGPT, which is like a IT expert next to you, said works quite well overall. Yeah, so in this video, I wanted to take a look at Scott Ritter, who, based on Wikipedia, was an intelligence officer in the U.S. Marine Corps, a then military analyst during Operation Desert Storm, and then an inspector of the non-existent weapons of mass destruction in Iraq, which he resigned from in protest. So he was also arrested and convicted for sex offenses, which also included children, and served a 2.5-year prison sentence. In recent years, he contributed to Russian state media outlets like RT and Sputnik, and visited Russia to promote peace in the Russian-Ukrainian war. Apparently, US authorities seized his passport to prevent him from further travels. So recently, the FBI raided his home and confiscated electronic devices for openly criticizing US war policies. As a military expert in his podcasts and his interviews, and for supporting Russia. Here I wanted to take a look at his body language to better understand his role and position in current events and to see who can be trusted in these difficult times. Okay, let's get started. So here we see him come out of his house, presumably after the FBI raid took place.
So I'm gonna run over here. All right, as you guys figured out, the FBI executed a search warrant at my residence. The search warrant is related to a concern.
So interestingly, he comes out and doesn't even wait for any questions. He just gives a little speech or statement, and the reporters seem particularly young and inexperienced, more like the local high school news team, which I find strange.
Apparently the U.S. government has about violations of the Foreign Agent Registration Act. I will tell you right now, I am not in violation of the Foreign Agent Registration Act. I have not done anything that will do it, and hopefully...
Because he doesn't answer anyone's specific question, he looks left and right. He can't address a single person, which is a bit strange. So he does use illustrators, which are his hand movements, which is generally, if they are congruent with speech, a sign of truth-telling. But here they seem robotic and forced.
By executing the search warrant and taking the materials that they did, they will rapidly reach that conclusion. I will say that things like this have a chilling effect on free...
Chilling effect on free speech. So the chilling effect he uses 5 times in 2 little interviews I will show, or 2 little video clips. But it's an odd phrase, and it indicates that his statements are rehearsed.
Things like this have a chilling effect on free speech. There's no doubt that I'm being targeted because of statements I've made about U.S. policy in Ukraine. I'm being targeted because I have made an effort to try and improve relations between the United States and Russia to try to bring about arms control.
So these people look extremely inexperienced. She looks like 15, so not sure what is going on here.
To bring about peace. Apparently somebody in the U.S. government takes umbrage at this, so they executed a search warrant. The FBI was extraordinarily professional. I have no complaints against the personnel that did this. I do have complaints against...
So he seems very understanding, which you often find in these kind of statements, which is very strange. There's no sign of anger and frustration.
The personnel that caused this to happen. This has a chilling impact on free speech.
So again, chilling effect, and now he reinforces it with his hand claps. So there's these illustrators, but they're quite simple and they can be trained, especially if you know you're going to use that phrase in conjunction with hand clapping, for instance. So that's a little package of behavior which you can train.
The idea that you have a free speech right in America when you execute it in a manner that the U.S. government takes exception to, and they launch a search warrant.
So he also points backward often with his fingers and hands, pointing at his house to illustrate where the raid was. So he also uses the same illustrators again and again. So it looks very robotic.
That is an intimidation factor. I can say that I am not intimidated, and I will continue to speak out, and I will continue to do what I do. Because
he says he's not intimidated, so the question is, why not? He's a person who would know what can be done to people who go against the government, so why would he not be concerned? It seems unnatural not to be.
That's my responsibility as an American citizen, and I will continue to operate in that manner. So I think I gave you all the answers you need at this point in time. I would request that you respect that. And let me and my wife get on with our business.
What time did they show up?
So now he says he wants to get back. But I mean, how can you just continue with your life without phones and laptops? You can't do anything, really. What he can do is mow the lawn, if that's what he means. And the second thing is he sends the reporters off. But why are they there in the first place? They don't just come along with a raid. So he must have called them because he wants the support in this difficult time. And to get the support, you would imagine he wants to have as much publicity as possible. But he now just sends him off after this little statement, which I find strange. At the same time, there's no concern on his face. So why have the reporters there in the first place, if he's not concerned and intimidated?
So I think I gave you all the answers you need at this point in time. I would request that you respect that and let me and my wife get on with our business.
What time did they show up today?
So he sends him off. But then he sticks around to answer more questions, and he doesn't even know when they came to do the raid.
I don't know. They were here a long time.
So, yeah. Can you say generally?
So he's laughing as well, like it's something funny. But he must be concerned with all his personal items removed. Who wants the FBI to look all through all the files on your laptop? I wouldn't want that.
What type of stuff was in the boxes they took?
The search warrant allowed them to look for electronic equipment. They were clearly interested in communications that I've had with people related to the work I do. That's all I can say about it. It's up to them to review it.
So shoulder shrug, like he doesn't care, even so it's all his personal items apparently. There's nothing he can do at this moment anymore. He can't even order a pizza anymore.
I have nothing to hide. I was cooperative with them. And
nothing to hide. Personal items, there's always something you don't want people to see. And here, shoulder shrug.
Cooperative with them, and, you know, we'll...
Shoulder shrug, he doesn't really care even.
It is what it is.
It is what it is, and smiles. Like there's anything funny about this. You should be concerned.
We'll get on with it. But as I said, I respect their right to do what they did. I'm not in violation of the law, and I will not be intimidated. So anybody upstairs who thought that this was... intimidate me and cause me to stop speaking out, they guessed wrong.
Did they take your passport from you about a couple weeks ago?
They took that. That's an old story, but yeah, my passport was seized when I returned from Russia back in June, when I was getting ready to leave from Russia back in June.
When you say they took stuff that was related to your work, what work exactly?
I'm a writer. You figure it out. You're a journalist. Imagine if they did a search warrant in your workplace. What would they take?
Fair enough.
Thank you.
So here's it's another perspective of the same interview, sort of from the front.
He takes umbrage at this, so they executed a search warrant. The FBI was extraordinarily professional. I have no complaints against the personnel that did.
Strange to have not any complaints if someone raids your house for 5 hours.
Did this? I do have complaints against the personnel that caused this to happen. This has a chilling impact on free speech. The idea that you have a free speech right in America, when you execute it in a manner that the U.S. government takes exception to, and they launch a search warrant, that is an intimidation factor. I can say that I am not intimidated, and I will continue to speak out, and I will continue to do what I do, because that's my responsibility as an American citizen, and I will continue to operate in that manner.
My responsibility as an American citizen, so he's basically calling to action. He's expecting other people to do something similar. So basically, that leads to further escalation.
So I think I gave you all the answers you need at this point in time. I would request that you respect that and let me and my wife get on with our business.
What time did they show up today?
I don't know. They were here a long time.
So here we see him laughing and not knowing when they came, even so he had hours to think about it while the FBI was raiding his home.
So, you know.
Can you say generally what type of stuff was in the boxes they took?
The search warrant allowed them to look for electronic equipment. They were clearly interested in communications that I've had with people related to the work I do. That's all I can say about it. It's up to them to review it. I have nothing to hide. I was cooperative with them, And, you know, well, it is what it is, and we'll get on with it. But as I said...
Again, smiles like he doesn't care, shoulder shrugs, like he looks indifferent to the whole scenario. Okay, so finally, here's another recording from the same day. He did apparently on his sofa in his living room or something like that. Let's see what he has to say.
Hello, as everybody's probably figured out by now, the FBI has executed a search warrant on my home.
So he does this a lot in this interview. He presses his lips together. That's a sign of self-constraining, of concealing information by essentially preventing himself from speaking more by sipping his lips. That's quite characteristic. Not a particular good sign.
Warrant was based upon.
And he looks at his notes. So he does this also quite a bit here. Reading of some notes or looking at some notes is not a problem, but here he gives the impression it was spontaneous, sitting on his sofa. That's a bit strange to send half these notes when you give the impression that it's something different.
What they deem to be probable cause that I am in violation of the Foreign Agent Registrations Act, and they executed a search warrant
again
for electronic devices, my computers, my cell phone, things of that nature, based upon...
So again, we see the looking and the compression of the lips already for the third time.
Their questions, it appears that they are primarily concerned about my relationship with RT and Sputnik, or specifically that I am receiving direction from RT and Sputnik and I'm being compensated, and that means that I am working on behalf of the Russian government. I am a journalist and I get compensated for my work. We shall see where it goes.
Here he is laughing. Shall see where it goes. Like very indifferent, not angry at all. I find this very strange.
They were in my house for 5.5 hours.
5.5 hours. They raided his house and he's laughing.
It's very professional, very courteous.
And he is praising them.
I have no problems with the people who executed the search warrant.
No problems. So he's repeating a speech from earlier, you know, you noticed. So essentially it's the same speech, similar wording.
I do have a problem with the search warrant itself. Let's just be very clear. No crime has been committed. I am not a foreign agent. I am not in violation of the Foreign Agent Registration Act. And they know this. This was an act of intimidation by the U.S. government designed to have a chilling effect.
Chilling effect again?
I was accused of...
Let's jump forward.
People. This is absurd in the extreme. This raid on my home was designed to have a chilling effect.
Again? So that was the fourth time, I think?
To make me think twice about speaking out, about writing, about doing podcasts. And as I told the FBI, and I'll tell you now, there isn't a snowball's chance in hell that I'll back.
So he compressed his lips again, concealing information.
Down because I'm doing nothing wrong. I'm doing what every concerned American should be doing when they believe.
So he says what concerned Americans should be doing. So that's a call to action, escalating the situation further.
Government is behaving in a manner that doesn't conform with the values and principles that are set forth by the Founding Fathers in the Constitution of the United States of America. I am an American citizen holding my government accountable and exercising the rights given to me by the Constitution. Today, the United States government declared war on me. They declared war on my ability to write, my ability to speak, my ability to interact with the American people, and indeed with a broader international audience. So be it. We're at war.
Very strong language.
It's not a war.
And he pressed his lips together again.
War I plan on losing, and I can tell you that there is no chilling effect. Look forward.
That's a chilling effect.
To seeing me in the future, as soon as I get the ability.
And he's laughing.
To interact more efficiently.
Even so, his equipment is all taken. All his personal information is scrutinized by the FBI, and he's laughing. Okay, in conclusion, he gave essentially the speech twice, once in front of his house and then on his sofa, using similar language, including similar phrasings or the same phrasings, like chilling effect, 5 times, in fact, I counted. And he called concerned U.S. citizens to action. He used war rhetoric. So the situation is essentially heating up more now. So based on the similar phrases he uses and also the body language in front of his house, and of course looking at the notes, that seems to be rehearsed, this little speech. So personally, I think people with significant public range on social media are likely planted there. So by providing a high level of truthful information, people tend to follow them, tend to trust them, especially then when they do something like calling to action or if they try to influence their thinking in a certain way. So hopefully you found this little analysis helpful. Thank you for watching and commenting under the video, and I talk to you next time. Bye.